Welcome to FootballGamePlan.com, where football makes sense. I'm Emory Hunt, the czar of the playbook here with Teron Davenport, Chris James, and we're at the 2017 East-West Shrine Game. West practices, day two, practice number four. Chris, what were some of your takeaways?
You know, I was extremely impressed again for the second straight day with how physical the defensive backs were and how they actually ball hawked today. A couple of pick sixes, some nice plays from the guys playing center field as well.
What about you, Teron?
Yeah, I'm going to piggyback off of that. I think Thomas Dekou looked really good. Treston Dekou looked really good. But a guy that I definitely was looking for coming into this week was Paul McGlure out of Arizona. And the thing that impressed me was just the way that he consistently flew to the football. There were a couple times in running drills or the team period where he came up and he filled very nicely. So he would be the standout for me from that perspective.
I look at the fact that they had some great interior offensive line play. I thought the offensive line redeemed themselves this practice against that defensive line. We saw them yesterday had some issues with those guys in one-on-one drills. I thought the offensive line, Zach Johnson of North Dakota State, you also look at the fact that the tackle from Texas A&M, he had a good day, and also the center. I can't remember these guys' names, but we'll look at it and talk about it on the podcast. But I thought the offensive line redeemed themselves. And also Jalen Robinette, the wide receiver of Air Force. He's a smooth receiver, and I thought he played well.
Absolutely. He had an outbreaking route, one-handed catch. I posted that on Twitter earlier today. And it was one of those where he just did what a receiver was supposed to do and didn't give up, located the ball, even though he didn't lock onto it till the last possible second and made a play.
I think just another receiver we have to mention is Billy Brown and just his route running ability. CJ, we were talking about that. You know, he's not the fastest guy, but he's crafty with his routes. He knows how to set it up. There was one point where he turned the DB around completely, made the catch on the curl. The guy catches everything also. So the first step in having a good receiver, a guy who's going to go to the next level, is to have consistent hands. He has that for sure.
There's a bunch of other guys and a lot of other tidbits we'll give you guys after this video on our podcast this evening, where we'll talk about more in detail of what we saw from both the East and the West practice today, players that stood out, and other highlights that we were able to notice. But right now, here are some of the sights, some of the sounds, and some of the highlights from today's West practice.
Here we go. don't rest. Work all day. When will I learn? Work all day.